from the start stabilization, from the start with civilization, many scientists would have attempted that. So plants are classified into that organism. It means from start with the civilization, so many scientists would have attempted that. Okay, so it means to classify living organism, to classify living organism. So scientists attempt to classify living organism many times, but only for their need. Okay, so to use, okay, for own food, shelter and clothes. But so they did not depend upon the scientific method. It means they do not use scientific method. Okay, only living organisms are classified depend upon their, okay, it means need for to use for own food, shelter and clothes. They do not use scientific method. For the first time, so using scientific method, living organisms classify into plants and animals by the first time Aristotle scientist for the first time living organisms are grouped into plants and animals by the using of scientific method. It is also objective, it is important objective bit. So how it classify that plants and how it is classify that living organism into plants and animals. For example, plants are plants are classified into three groups based on some morphology, based on simple morphological characters. So what are the three groups? Herbs, shrubs, third one is the trees. What is the meaning of the herbs? Small, delicate, so green plants are known as that herbs. Small and delicate, green plants are known as that herbs. Stem is completely green in color. Shrubs, bush-like appearance of plants. Bush-like plants are known as the shrubs. Next, trees, hard and woody plants. So plants are known as that trees. So based on the simple morphological characters, After that, animals. Animals are divided into two groups. So, those having that RBC, with RBC, and second one is without RBC. With RBC and without RBC. So, these animals are divided into two groups, with RBC and without RBC. With RBC means, so, with red blood cells, okay? And some animals having that RBC are absent. They are known as without RBC. So, these are the animals and these are the plants. So, for the first time, so it means living organisms are divided into plants and animals by Aristotle scientist. Aristotle scientist based on scientific method. Based on scientific method. So that is that objective bit. Plants are but the first time by Aristotle by the using of scientific method. So plants are classified into three groups based on simple morphological characters, herbs, shrubs and trees. Next, animals are divided into two groups, presence of RBC and without RBC. Okay, so after that, Aristotle, so many scientists are, okay, classify living organisms, okay, into different groups. But what is that, okay, so two kingdom classification. After that, two kingdom classification. Two kingdom classification. This two kingdom classification is, okay, for the first time proposed by that, Carolus von Linnaeus scientist. Carolus von Linnaeus scientist, okay, plants are divided, it means living organisms are divided into two kingdoms. It means living organisms divided into two kingdoms. So what are that? First one is that plant A, second one is animalia. Second one is animalia. Okay, so that is known as Linnaeus classification or two kingdom classification. So these living organisms are divided into two kingdoms. First one is the plant A, second one is the animalia, based on cell wall. Based on cell wall. If which living organism having the cell wall, all the plants, presence of cell wall. Presence of cell wall, that is known as the plant A. So, absent of cell wall. Absent of cell wall. So, that is known as that animalia or animals. Animalia means animals. So, plant A means plants. Right? So, presence of cell wall and absent of cell wall. Right? So, in this one, he did not differentiate other characters. Only he take that for classification of living organism. So, what are that living character? It is known as the presence of cell wall. Only he take that presence of cell wall for consideration of classification of living organism, plant and animalia. But he did not, okay, follow that other characters. So, that's why it is known as the two kingdom classification. So, so the system of classification is also, okay, present. It means this two kingdom classification is, what are that merits? It is easily understood. It is easily to understand and it is easily to classify and it is easily to study. So that is known as a two kingdom classification. But he did not consider that other characters. So what are that other characters? For example, he did not differentiate. He did not differentiate What are the prokaryotic and eukaryotic? Prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Second one, unicellular. After that, multicellular. Third one, autotrophic. Second one, after that, heterotrophic condition. Heterotrophic condition. Don't differentiate that. Prokaryotic and eukaryotic, unicellular and multicellular, autotrophic and heterotrophic conditions. Right? So, it means, what is the meaning? It means, it did not differentiate prokaryotic and eukaryotic. So, for example, you take that in the plants. For example, algae, fungi, bacteria, plantae. In plants, what are that? Bryophytes, pteridophytes, and gymnosperms and angiosperms. So this all are belongs to that plantae. Okay, algae, fungi, bacteria, bryophyta, pteridophyte, gymnosperms and angiosperms. All are belongs to that, what are that? Plantae. Okay, so only he did not differentiate that. It means, for example, you take that prokaryotic. So what are that prokaryotic? Bacteria and blue-green algae. Generally, they are the prokaryotic, but they are also included to that which one? Algae, fungi, bryophyta and pteridophyta. It means only presence of, he take that for classification of the plants, only he take that presence of cell wall, not okay, considered to that other characters. Okay, so that's why, so it is one demerit. It means only he did not differentiate that what is the meaning prokaryotic and eukaryotic, unicellular and multicellular. For example, you take that unicellular. Unicellular means unicellular algae that is known as the Chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas. Next, multicellular algae. So, both these are Spirogyra. Both are belongs to that green algae. But what is the difference? Unicellular Chlamydomonas or multicellular Spirogyra. But according to the Linnaeus, this two algae are belongs to that plants. It means only presence of cell wall. So both are belongs to that plants. But he did not differentiate that unicellular and multicellular. Chlamydomonas and Spirogyra both are belongs to that plants. Okay. Next, generally algae are autotrophic, fungi are heterotrophic condition. Okay. Next one. Algae and plants. So generally they are autotrophic. Okay, so they synthesize their food material by their own, by the process of photosynthesis process. By photosynthesis process. But you take that fungi. Fungi is heterotrophic condition. So they did not prepare their own food material. Depend upon that other organism. So that is known as heterotrophic condition. But only presence of cell wall, they are belongs to that. So what is the meaning? So plants, not differentiate that autotrophic and heterotrophic. For example, you take that in the plants, cell wall is composition is also different. Plant cell wall is made up of cellulose, right? In fungi, cell wall is made up of chitin. It means what is the meaning? Cell wall material is also different, sir. So plant cell wall having the cellulose, fungi cell wall having the chitin. But both are belongs to that plants, only depend upon the presence of cell wall. If cell wall material composition is also different, so he did not consider, so both are belongs to that plants, only presence of cell wall. That's why, so for long time his classification is not okay continue. So it means it is not sufficient. Okay, so it is not enough to classify living organism. So what are the characters are required to classify living organism? It means gross morphology is required. Next, cell wall and cell structure and habitat, mode of nutrition, reproduction, body organization, and phylogenetic system. It means phylogenetic means it is an evolutionary character. Phylogenetic, it means evolutionary characters. Evolutionary characters. So these characters are needed to classify that living organism. But in Linnaeus, only he take that only one character. It means what are that need for classify living organism? First one is a gross morphology, cell wall, cell structure, habitat, mode of nutrition, reproduction, body organization, and phylogenetic. Okay, it means evolutionary characters are required to classify living organisms, right? After that, so many scientists propose the different type of system of classification. In this, so accepted, so all scientists are accepted that, so that is known as proposed that R.H. Whittaker. It is known as five kingdom classification. Five kingdom classification. So in that five kingdom classification, he considered that five characters. For example, cell structure, thallus organization, mode of nutrition, and reproduction, and phylogenetic. And phylogenetic means evolutionary relationship. Evolutionary relationship. So archivity of five kingdom classification, cell structure, thallus organization, mode of nutrition, reproduction, phylogenetic, and evolutionary relationship. So this means five characters considered for that five kingdom classification. So what are that five kingdoms? First one is the Monera. Second one is Protista. Third one is the Fungi, Plantae, and fifth one is that Animalia. Right? So first one is that Monera, second one is a Protista, third one is a Fungi, fourth one is a Plantae, fifth one is that Animalia. It means five characters and so five kingdoms. So this five kingdom classification, this is a five kingdom classification proposed by that R.H. Whittaker scientist, and five characters: cell structure, thallus organization, mode of nutrition, reproduction, and phylogenetic means evolutionary relationship. So they are that five kingdom classification. According to that R. H. Whittaker, so he make that column. He explained that characters. What are that? Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, after that Animalia, after that Animalia, right? So these are the characters. What are the type of cell? Next, second one, cell wall composition. Body organization, next, mode of nutrition, body organization, nuclear membrane. Okay, 1 minute. Cell wall composition, nuclear membrane, third one, nuclear membrane, body organization or thallus organization, after then fifth one, mode of nutrition. For example, you take that Monera, in that Protista, after that Fungi, after the Plantae, after that Animalia. In type of cell, for example, you take that Monera. So that is known as that prokaryotic. Prokaryotic. Okay, next, cell wall composition, non-cellulosic. It is made up of polysaccharide plus amino acid, mucopeptide and muramic acid generally. Nuclear membrane is absent. Next, body organization, cellular. Next, mode of nutrition. Mode of nutrition means it is a different type. Somewhere it is a photosynthetic, it means photosynthetic. Autotrophic. Chemosynthetic. Autotrophic or heterotrophic. Non-photosynthetic, some are parasites. Okay, so it means different type of the mode of nutrition is present. Some are photosynthetic, autotrophic and chemosynthetic, autotrophic and heterotrophic and non-photosynthetic and symbiosis, and some are parasitic condition, right? So in this, after them Protista. So in that Protista, it is a eukaryotic, it is a unicellular. After that, cell wall composition is, sometimes it is that cellulose, Okay, so it means after the nuclear membrane is present, a different nuclear membrane is present around the nucleus, body organization, cellular. Next, mode of nutrition, photosynthetic, autotrophic, heterotrophic, saprophytes, and some are parasitic, just like the mode of nutrition. Okay, so prokaryotes. Next one is that fungi. It is also eukaryotic. After that, cell wall is made up of that chitin, non-cellulosic substance. Okay, so nuclear membrane is present. Body organization, cellular loose tissue, loose tissue. Okay, mode of nutrition, most of that heterotrophic and saprophytic, heterotrophic and saprophytic. So after that, some are parasitic and symbiosis. Right, plant A are eukaryotic, cell wall is that cellulose. Next, nuclear membrane is present, tissue and tissue system. Next, it is that autotrophic, photosynthetic.